Hello, children. Welcome. This is Rajni, ma'am. Class 6th standard, subject mathematics. This is continuation of unit 3, and the unit name is playing with numbers. So this is continuation of the exercise. This is 7th one. The product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Verify this statement with the example. So here it is given that the product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Okay, if you take three consecutive numbers, so the product, so when you multiply, what you get, the product of three consecutive numbers, that the product is divisible by 6. So we have to verify this statement with an example. So solution, the product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6, verification. So example, so we go through the example and we prove it that three consecutive numbers are divisible by 6. So consecutive numbers means one after the other. So for example, the first one, 2 into 3 into 4. So 2, 3 and 4 are three consecutive numbers. So these three consecutive numbers will multiply and check. Multiply and write the product and check whether the product what we get is divisible by 6 or not. So first example, the three consecutive numbers, that is 2 into 3 into 4. So three consecutive numbers will multiply. That is 2, 3 is 6. 6, 4 is 24. So we are getting here product. So when we took three consecutive numbers and multiply it and we got product, that is 24. So here what we got, the product 24 is divisible by 6 or no? Yes, 24 is divisible by 6. That is 6 into 4. 6, 4 is 24. So here, when we took three consecutive numbers and multiplied and we got the product, that is 24 is divisible by 6. So therefore, the product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Okay. So when you're taking any three consecutive numbers, after multiplying, what we get, the product, that product is divisible by 6. So for the first example, 2 into 3 into 4. So 2, 3 and 4 are three consecutive numbers. So when we multiply, we are getting here product 24. So here the product 24 is divisible by 6. Okay, that is 6, 4 is 24. So this was first example. The next one, the three consecutive numbers, that is 6, 7 and 8. Okay, 6 into 7 into 8. Consecutive numbers are one after the other. So that we took three consecutive numbers, that is 6, 7 and 8. So now we multiply and write the product and check whether product is divisible by 6. So 6 into 7 into 8, which is equal to how much? 336. So when we multiply 6 into 7 into 8, we are getting here product 336. So we check whether 336 is divisible by 6. Yes, it is divisible by 6. That is 6 into 56 is 336. Okay. 6 into 56 is 336. So when we took three consecutive numbers, that is 6, 7 and 8, when we multiply and we get the product, that product is divisible by 6. So therefore, the product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Okay. So when we are taking any three consecutive numbers, so when we multiply and we write the product, that product is divisible by 6. So therefore, the product of three consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. The next one, 8. The sum of two consecutive numbers, odd numbers, is divisible by 4. Verify this statement. Okay, it is said that the sum of two consecutive numbers. So when you take two consecutive numbers and add it, that sum is divisible by 4. So we have to verify this statement. To verify, so we will use some examples. So solution, the sum of two consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4, verifications. So first example, so we will take two consecutive odd numbers, okay? Odd numbers of that 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on are the odd numbers. So we will take two consecutive odd numbers, that is 3 plus 5, okay? 3 is an odd number here and 5 is also odd number. So consecutive odd number, after 3, the odd number is 5. So we took here two consecutive odd numbers and we'll add it. What we get the sum, that is answer, we'll check whether it is divisible by 4 or not. So example, first one, we took two consecutive odd numbers, that is 3 plus 5. 3 and 5. 3 plus 5 is how much? 3 plus 5 is 8. So whether 8 is divisible by 4? Yes, that is 4 into 2. 4 2 is 8. So therefore, 3 plus 5, which is equal to 8, 8 is divisible by 4. That is 4 2 is 8. So when we are taking two consecutive odd number, what we are getting the sum is divisible by 4. Okay, we have verified with an example. The next second example. Next, we are taking another two different consecutive, that is two consecutive odd numbers, that is 7 and 9. So when we add it, that is 7 plus 9, which is equal to 7 plus 9 is 16. So whether 16 is divisible by 4? Yes, 16 is divisible by 4. That is 4. 4 into 4 is how much? 16. So here the sum 16 is divisible by 4. Okay, so when we are taking two consecutive odd number, when we add it, the sum is divisible by 4. So the last third example, that we took the next two consecutive odd numbers, that is 39 and 15. Okay, so when we add 39 and 15, we are getting here answer 28. So whether 28 is divisible by 4? Yes, that is 4 7 is 28. Okay, so 28 is divisible by 4, that is 4 7 is 28. So therefore, when we are taking two consecutive odd numbers, so when we add two consecutive odd numbers, what we get the sum is divisible by 4. So therefore, with this example, we prove that the sum of two consecutive odd numbers is always divisible by 4. So whatever two consecutive odd numbers you take, when you add the two consecutive odd numbers, what you get the sum is divisible by 4. Okay, so therefore the sum of two consecutive odd numbers is always divisible by 4. The next one, determine if 25110 is divisible by 45. Okay, that is 25,110 is divisible by 5. We have to determine it. So we have to check whether 25,110 is divisible by 45. So solution, the factors to find whether 25,110 is divisible by 45. So first we write the factors of 9 and 5. The factors of 45 are, first we write the factors of 45. So the factors of 45 are 9 and 5. 9 5 is 45. So in 45 is divisible by 9 and even divisible by 5. So the factors of 45 are 9 and 5. So therefore, if the number 25,110 is divisible by 9 and 5, then the number 25,110 is divisible by 45 also. Okay. So first, to find the given number 25110 is whether divisible by 45. So first we wrote the factors of 45. That is, the factors of 45 are 995. So first we check whether the given number 25110, that is 25,110, is divisible by 995. If it is divisible by 995, then 25,110 is divisible by 45 also. Okay. So if the number 25110 is divisible by 9 and 5, then the number 25110 is divisible by 45 also. So first we check whether the given number 25110 is divisible by 995. So the given number we'll write next, that is 25,110, that is 25110. So first we check the divisibility by 9 and then we check the divisibility by 5. So if it is divisible by 9 and 5 both, then that number will be divisible by 45 also. So first we write the given number 25110. So to check the divisibility by 9, we add digits. The sum must be divisible by 9. So the given number 25110, to check the divisibility by 9, what we do? First we add all the digits of the given number. So when we add, what we get the answer, that should be divisible by 9. If it is divisible by 9, then whole number is divisible by 9. So the sum must be divisible by 9 here. So the given number is what? 25110. So we'll add all the digits. So therefore 2 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0, which is equal to how much? 9. 5 plus 2 is 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. So we are getting here answer sum how much? 9. Whether 9 is divisible by 9? Yes, 9 once is 9. So therefore, thus the sum 9 is divisible by 9. Then the whole number, that is therefore 25,110, is divisible by 9. So we have checked that the number 25,110 is divisible by 9. Now we check the same number whether it is divisible by 5. So to check divisibility by 5, what we do? We check last digit of the given number. If the given digit is having last digit, it is having the last digit 0, then the whole number is divisible by 5. Okay. So to check divisibility by 5, the last digit of the given number must be what? 0. Okay. For the given number, the last number must be 0. If it is 0, then whole number is divisible by 5. So to check the divisibility by 5, the last digit of the given number must be 0. So therefore, for the given number 25110, that is 25,110, the last digit is what here? 0. That is 25110. Last is 0 here. So given number 25110 is divisible by 5. Okay, to check divisibility by 5, for the given number, last digit must be 0. So here last digit is 0. So whole number 25110, that is 25,110, is divisible by 5. So therefore, the given number 25,110 is divisible by 9 and even 5. So when it is divisible by 5, 9 and 5, then it is divisible by 45 also, because here 9 and 5 are factors of 45. Okay. So therefore, here the given number 25110, that is 25,110, is divisible by 995 both. So then it is divisible by 45 also, because here 995 are factors of 45. So when the given number 510, that is 25,110, is divisible by 995, then it is divisible by 45 also. Okay, children, go through this exercise problems, solve and practice it. We'll continue this unit exercise in next video part. Thank you.